our first day off in like 2 weeks. Man, you know, it feels pretty good to not have to be bothered by the manager. Oh no. God damn it. Hello? What do you mean you have a small issue? It better be the manager has come down with an illness and he's just fucking not there anymore. You have an unidentified machine in the hangar and you need me to inspect it. God damn it, on my day off too, huh? Alright, well, I want overtime. Alright. Yeah, I'll be there. I'll be there pretty soon. I'll see you. God damn it!
You see what I mean? This is a goddamn prison. And I'm its prisoner. I can't even get one day off.
What the hell is that?
That, my four-eyed friend, is Mechagodzilla Unit 01.
First off, bitch. Second off, what the hell is a Mechagodzilla?
It's Mechagodzilla Unit 01, or some call it Kiryu. Put some damn respect on its name, for Christ's sakes, you heathen. Oh god, great, you just upset the investors, Crow. Tanaka-san, wa bakana kuroso, yuroshite kurasai, skiryo, sakujo, shinaide kurasai.
Whatever, you little shit. Look, it's not covered in any of the SOPs. None of the publications have this anywhere listed. How can I conduct a safety inspection without knowing what I'm looking for to inspect?
Who needs paperwork when you have all of your 6 months of experience?
14 years.
14 years experience! It hasn't been promoted! I wouldn't go around telling people that I've been forced to hold the same job for years without promotion, a pay raise, or even a good vacation.
Probably because I love my job, and I love doing it.
Whatever. How about you earn your paycheck and figure it out? I'm going to go talk to Inspector Fluffy-kun. You're a good inspector, aren't you? That's right, Fluffy. You know not to upset Mr. Tanaka, who signs our paycheck. Good dog. Kawaii, Fluffy. Of course, Crow doesn't speak Japanese, Fluffy. I know. Baka, you know.
The man's a goddamn lunatic, and the only way I can stop him is if he just happens to have an accident in the hangar, or they gotta take matters into my own hands. You're not gonna put that in the video, right? Right? Alright guys, look, this thing's in here, I guess it's been authorized. That's not my department to authorize the machinery to come into the hangar for the inspections. My job is to do the inspections, alright? We'll figure it out, I guess. If anything, we're breaking ground by adding this new thing to the paperwork. Luckily it does come with some details about it, so we can go ahead and assess it and just try and work our way through it, man. That's the best thing I can do for you guys. So, let's go ahead and start off where the manufacturing came from. It's unknown. The best place that you could possibly get any kind of parts relating to it is Hobby Link Japan. So, do with that as you must. You can go ahead and check them out if there is any parts available. But yeah, this is kind of like a big question mark. Okay, so let's start with the overall name, which is quite a mouthful. So I have it labeled here as the MFS-3, which is the Multi-Purpose Fighting System Type 3. That's the official designation, but it also has the other name, Mechagodzilla. But then it has another name, apparently. It has a code name, Kiryu, which translates to Machine Dragon. Jesus, why do we need all these names? But whatever. I mean, the Gundam has the RX-78-2. I think it's also called just Gundam, and then it's also called White Devil or some shit like that. So, you know, it's not too far-fetched from what we've already been doing with the Gundam series. All right, now for the height. It comes in at 60 meters tall. That is a pretty big boy. I mean, we're averaging, what, about 18 meters in height for a lot of our Gundams? You know, sometimes at the most we're going like 23 meters, so 60 meters, I mean, this is a very, very big machine, as you can see. Alright, so the weight, this is 40,000 tons of just raw alloy, and that's kind of leading into the overall armor. A bunch of question marks. Once again, it's an alloy, but even alloy has a question mark, so no one here actually knows what the hell this metal is. Maybe it's from fucking Saturn. I don't know. Like, this is actually frustrating that we have no clue what this thing is, where it's made from, where it came from. It just kind of appeared. That's all. Yeah, you could thank the manager for that one. All right, let's look at the overall details. I mean, it looks good on the outside. I'm not seeing any kind of like major kinks in the armor. It does obviously for the joints going to have like some kind of padding. Overall, I don't have a problem with it. It has a decent frame. I'm also reading here that inside, it has the bones of a giant lizard that once ravished Tokyo in the 1950s. Am I living in a science fiction story? I mean, I have an actual profession. I am a professional here. And you're telling me this thing just has bones from a giant lizard from the 1950s. I don't believe it, but I don't even want to look. I don't even want to try and inspect that. Just I'll assume that this is just a gag on me. So let's move on. Now the overall color scheme is going to be coming in a green and a purple. And obviously it's going to be like some black and gray. They're saying that key note here is that it is based on the Ava Unit 1. I don't know what the Ava Unit 1 is. That is just something that is a note of here, but doesn't give any kind of reference to. So this technically, what I'm saying here is not the original color scheme. It should have been a more silverish color scheme, but it's now the Ava Unit 1 colors. So yeah, take with that as you will. All right, let's just move right into the articulation. This is not the best articulated thing. I might even call it a mobile suit. It's a thing. That's the best thing I can describe it. The overall body can kind of move in a very, I guess, dragon-like posture. And that's kind of what you want, right? That's what I'm guessing for this. But overall, you're not getting like more than like a 90-degree bend on the knees. The elbows can pretty much do a little bit over a 90-degree bend, which is fine. And you know, the overall body has good joints, so I'm not seeing much of a safety hazard or safety issue with the posture and the mobility of the suit. Now for the hands, you are going to have kind of more of like a straight and just kind of like relaxed hands. Then you're also going to have these kind of like more dynamic claw postured hands. So that's kind of most of what you're getting when it comes to these hands or any kind of limbs. Now for the eyes, you're going to have these yellow eyes, which look really good, but you're also going to have the red eyes. There's no explanation. You just get two different color eyes. So, yep. Now on the side of the legs, they are going to have these kind of compartments that just open up, and it's going to expose these thrusters. So that's pretty cool. So it does have the extra thrust power when wanting to dash or even go into the air. All right, so pretty much all the details and everything is covered. Let's move on to the test site, and we'll go ahead and strap on that backpack and explore all the weaponry. I'll be seeing you guys out there. Alright guys, welcome to the test site. So the first thing we're going to take a look at is going to be the Absolute Zero cannon that's built into the chest. So this thing freezes the opponent, which is really cool. Just opens up and bam, blasts your opponent. Now this can also be combined with the mouth to form a mouth cannon, which is kind of like a burst of electricity and like a laser. So just trifecta of weaponry, which is it's okay. They're also going to have the dual laser cannons on each arm. Now, when they're deployed, they're basically going to be shooting outwards. It's fine, but it's just basic cannons. Then you're going to have two rocket launchers on the backpack. And the backpack does also have thrusters, so it's just going to be able to propel itself even further. But the two rocket launchers on the backpack is really nice, and I'm pretty sure that can definitely destroy any enemy that's coming towards it. And lastly, you're going to have these short blades, which are discharged on each arm, so it has two different short blades for that close combat, just in case the enemy is coming in close. But that pretty much wraps it up for all the weapons here. I don't have anything else in my notes, so let's go ahead and just head back to the hangar. Alright guys, so let's go ahead and debrief. Honestly, I don't even know what to say. I don't. I'm gonna say something personal, right? Our manager, the hangar manager, is inept. I didn't have to be the one to say that. I've been keeping it professional. But Jesus Christ, you just seen how difficult that was, trying to analyze some very handwritten patch notes about this thing, and now I have to go back to the SOP and annotate this machinery in our publications. So just in case we get another one or something similar, we have some notes to move on, like, to, you know, utilize. Other than that, guys, that's all I got. I don't have anything else. This is a goddamn joke. This whole place, it's a joke, so I will deem it necessary for combat use and for deployment, so get it ready, however, but when it gets destroyed, look, I don't have the parts necessary to order and replace anything that gets damaged. So when that thing gets destroyed or damaged, that's it. It's cut off. So I'm going to give it my anonymous and best wishes out there to whoever pilots this thing. But that's all for me, guys. Thank you to all the people who spectated this safety inspection, and thank you to the ones that assisted me in it. So, other than that, thank you all for watching and for participating, and I do expect the corrective actions relatively soon, so get that to me by the end of the week. But I'll be seeing you later. Bye-bye, guys.